Good evening and welcome to our Easter Songs of Praise, brought to you by members of our Ingleborough team of churches. As each one chooses their song, they'll also be saying something about why it is important to them. Easter separates the Christian faith from many of the others, indeed from all of the others. For ours is a faith about the cross which is empty. Ours is a resurrection faith. There is no body on this cross, for Jesus Christ is risen, and we celebrate that rising as we sing together tonight. Amen.
Hi everyone, the hymn that I've picked is I Am the Lord of the Dance. I've picked this hymn because it reminds me of singing it in school and on Sunday as well. I love to sing it at church. The tune always seems to be one that sticks in your head and you end up singing it all around the house as well afterwards. And the final thing I like about it is that the descriptions in each verse of Jesus and his interactions with people on his way to the cross seem to just conjure up an image that I can really see vividly in my head when I'm singing it.
So I'm going to ask Timothy, I'm going to move into the sunlight so you can shine into the sunlight. What's your favourite Easter hymn?
Definitely Lord of the Dance, because it is a hymn that you really want to dance to, and I think of dance as part of worship, and it expresses the words expressed, I think, at least some of the meaning of what Easter is all about, what resurrection means.
So what does resurrection mean then? For you this time in the time of coronavirus.
It means new life, it means hope, it means that whatever happens to us, God is on our side. If we're on his side, then God brings us through things.
Yeah. Wow, that's fun.
I
Hi everyone. Hello. It's really good to join you virtually. Thank you, Anne, for the invitation to share a little video and to choose a song for your Songs of Praise service this Easter day. Not quite the first Easter in our new parish that we were expecting, but things are going well, and we hope everything's going well with you all up in Yorkshire. And we hope once the restrictions are lifted at some point to be able to come up and see you all and say hello in person, because we really miss you all down here in sunny Luton. But thank you for the invitation to join you. Amanda's going to tell you which song we've chosen and why.
We would like the song See What a Morning, because we think the words just capture the spirit of Easter Day. See what a morning, gloriously bright, the dawning of new hope in Jerusalem. So we would like that. We hope you enjoy it. We will definitely be singing it here. So happy Easter to you all, and God bless.
And happy Easter and God bless from me too. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
The song I have chosen is See What a Morning, sometimes called the Resurrection Hymn. I've chosen it because I find it so uplifting, and it shows the victory that Jesus gave to us all on that day so long ago. I also feel that the words can speak to our current situation in the world, our country and our homes. It's a song of hope and salvation. And the words in verse 2 reach out to us. Mary hears Jesus speaking, calling out her name, and talks of the voice that spans the years, speaking life, stirring hope, bringing peace to us. And that voice will sound till he appears, for he lives. Christ is risen from the dead.
Oh, Go.
Hi, I'm Catherine, and I like, and my favourite hymn is Shine Jesus Shine, because it's happy and I know all the words.
Light of the world, shine upon us, set us free by the truth you
I've been asked to introduce an Easter hymn for you this morning, and one of my favourite hymns is the one that starts, "Low in the grave he lay." I just like the way it takes you from that sadness into the joy that is Easter. And it says, "Up from the grave he arose, with a mighty triumph o'er his foes." So here we go. "Low in the grave he lay."
As we conclude our time together, we just pray for those in need at this particular time. Those who have been touched by this virus. Those indeed that are affected by other medical needs right now and whose attention may well be on the virus. And we also pray for all those who are caring, those who are in the homes that help the aged and the infirm, for those in our National Health Service, for the doctors and the nurses. We lift them before God, that they may be blessed, that they may be encouraged in their role. And we conclude with this prayer. God of glory, by the raising of your Son, you have broken the chains of death and hell. Fill your church with faith and hope